Operations report. Uh-oh, S-47s. Better check on that one. A little tender loving care, and the ships are repaired. Seawolf and Trinity are back. Yeah, yeah, detection. No, detection. Oh, there's a recon. Yeah. Submarine detected, reported hit. Ah, who knows? Who knows? Right. Return to service. Lot of you. See, all you had to do was just a little bit of clicking and they went off. Switch them from the into peer side mode and they're done. But the AI just isn't able to do that. Captured Lashio, expansion. Oh, Karachi is up to 5, but we don't need it. We don't need it. It's so far in the rear. Replacements taken. Good. Sun and another one at Lahore. But we better take a look at that submarine right now. S-47. Let's take a look. Before we forget. S-47. Where are you? Oh, she's only... Oh, it's a minor... It's a minor ding. It's 20% only. So plenty of time. Here we are in China. Looking at the... damage here. Oh man, it went from 20 to 18 to 10. We're under 7,300, so disperse and defend for a little while. Here we're in. Okay, there we've got our 7,800 on here. Supplies are non-existent, but we're here. Let's blast these guys, right? Go to deliberate. Oops, let's make sure it's always infantry go to deliberate, not everybody. The engineers staying out of it. There's no artillery, so the engineers stay out of it. Why isn't this base force taking? Always take reinforcements, base forces. Now where is this unit going? It came out through here, ran down here. Where the hell is it going? Oh well, that just leaves one less unit to kill, I guess. Hope it's a big one. Maybe it's getting out of here. Over in Quelin, the base force has returned, so now I'm going to send it down to Gukong. Right? Because it does have a railway. Still getting nothing over here. Kunming. How far can we transfer these guys? Can we get them all the way to... I guess we could send them all the way out to... Calcutta in order to convert them up or down. The sky trains are being used right now. Let's see. The sky trains are over it here, but they're not taking reinforcements. I think they're because of their... lack of supply. Pool numbers insufficient. So I think I'm going to... there's only 5 flying right now. Let's transfer over to Calcutta. From here, we can draw a full. You're only allowed 12 replacements per month. Per week. Per week. So we've gotten our 12. We won't be able to get any more till next week. So that's good. There's 9 more here. I could send one of these other ones over here to grab the other 9, but I don't think I will. Until we get the other ones back. So we just grabbed up 12 more. Now this other group here. Look at this. This is number 31, and it has a detachment with it as well. So it's a detachment. But we can't combine them because, look, one is under Group RAF and the other one's under Air HQ India. That's just dumb. Okay, so we're going to take the one with the 2 units here, Air HQ India, and what was the other one? Oh, gosh. You can't even remember that. 221 Group RAF. Okay, so I'm going to change this one to 221 Group RAF. just so they can get them together. Done. For all of 2 points, I'll just do the damn thing. Reattach? Yeah. We'll get another pilot, too. So we've now got 3 aircraft here. Should we increase to the 5 aircraft? There aren't any other units using these aircraft, these DC-2s, and the Chinese use a different DC-2. See, we have 5 in the pool, whereas the Chinese have a different DC. Chinese DC-2 and Chinese DC-3, so it's not the same aircraft. We're not fighting for those kinds of resources. So if I have 3 aircraft now and I can get 5 aircraft functional, shouldn't I do it? I think so. So upgrade, and the next upgrade path is Dakota. Fine, but we'll wait until I see what I want to do with it. So we'll have 5 aircraft to replace the 3. I'm not going to pull these other 2 out just because, well, we've already pulled out 5 in order, 5 plus the 3 here, so I will update, or I'll grab reinforcements for these guys once the other ones come back. I'm going to plan for the relief of, we have a number of ships here that are withdrawing. Diamond Harbor, there's, well, not really immediate future, but 62, 25, and 46 days. I think I'm going to try to relieve these ships now so that I don't have to be less of a fight in case I have to fight my way out of here. So it's a carrier and 2 light cruisers scheduled to release. Unfortunately, we have in Colombo, we will form, there's carriers, but they also release. See, 214 days and Formidable in 91 days. So everybody leaves. But Illustrious is the one that stays the longest, so I'm going to form up with Illustrious and however many of these cruisers. Okay, we'll send Illustrious, Ceres, and Cape Town over, just because they're still going to leave. It just takes a long time for them to leave, that's all. So form Air Combat, Illustrious, Ceres, and Cape Town. How many of these, let's check the destroyers as well. I don't know how many of these guys are leaving. Oh, they aren't. So we can send them. I don't know what their anti-air value are, but we'll send these guys, okay? At least I don't have to worry about mucking around and trying to get them out. Let's check the destroyers over here. Let's check all of them, actually. Yeah, destroyers, are any of these 260 days, 254 days? Okay, so some of these will stay around to the end. So we're going to try to replace Hotspur and Fortune. They're going to be out, and the battleships will be withdrawing after 489 days, 500. So the battleships should be around for a lot longer. But Hotspur and Fortune are gone after 250 days. Not even a year. Okay, so those are the kinds of considerations we'll have to make here. So which ones aren't leaving? There's Norman. We'll send Norman. Norman and Decoy. Arrow and Decoy. Okay, Norman, Arrow, Decoy. Wow. 8 days, hell, you know, Just go already. Yeah, get out of here. And Panther, I believe. Yeah, okay. You're out of here. Thank you very much. So, Panther. Inconstant, Griffin. Oh, these are... Okay. So, transfer... Inconstant, Norman, Arrow, Decoy, right? Double check that. No. Inconstant has to stay. All right. Transfer is... Well, we can use them for escort now, is what I'll do. I'll make sure I use them for escort, and we're going to pull them out. Along with the other, along with the others, and we'll set a waypoint. Move in here, and then across. Oh, come on! Fine, we'll set a waypoint there and move across. Let's make sure the aircraft are actually flying. Illustrious, you've got albacore and martlets. Get them up! Get them up! How many pilots we got? We have 24. And we can have a total of 28. One third? Yeah, 28. So let's get some more good pilots on here, hopefully. Request fighter pilots. You're going into combat, so I'm taking the top ones. I'm taking the top five. Top guys every time. We're sending them into war. We owe it to them to give them the best. Plus, we've got lots of Canadian pilots. Albacore. She's already maxed out on hers. Okay. These are torpedo bombers, so we're going to go naval attack. Search 10%. Looks good. I'm going to keep it at medium, at regular range. Do we want to upgrade to Barracuda yet? No. These are albacore ones. Yeah, string bags. Swordfish, no, those are just as bad. Okay. At least this one will be around for 214 days, which is not a hell of a lot more, but better than, let's check the other carrier. Formidable, gone in 91 days. Is this carrier maximized? Illustrious has maximum number of aircraft. Good. So this always risky. Every time you put the ships out, you're always at risk of getting a torpedo, eating a torpedo from a submarine or from air attack. But we might as well switch them out now, when it's kind of quiet. Whoa, look at all that. Look at all that. Okay, unload it. Okay, one more turn to unload, and then back out you go. Let's, while we're waiting here, let's form surface. Let's replenish. I love it when it keeps telling me nothing changes, and then all of a sudden it changes. Well, where did we just get the fuel, guys? I hit replenish at sea, and nothing came from these guys. Okay, so nothing transferred. Did I just grab it from the dock when I ordered it? Didn't order it to take it from the dock. Okay. Transports due inbound. Escorts going outbound. Inbound. Outbound. Inbound. And outbound. All right, I think we've got escorts for all of them. Oh man, really? You got one ship here? You're going to hold up the entire... Yeah, you would. Yeah, I know you would. Okay. Tanker. Dock. Unload. Abaddon. Thank you. You other guys, get the hell out of here. If it would help if I told you where to go. Get the hell out of here to Abaddon. Are they undocked? Yes. Abaddon. Okay, we're almost filled, but there aren't any other ships waiting in dock, so we might as well... I'll just let them wait. Fill it up and then come. Any aircraft that need to be transferred forward? No. Let's take a look at Bombay. Any units, land units, need to come forward. We're going to take the Indian Command. Shuffle it. rebuild, and no, still lots of units coming. Indian Command, I think we will order them to combat, mainly because we can start using their engineers right now. We're still building Bombay. Every engineering vehicle helps. Submarine check. Yep, inbound, inbound, inbound. Everybody's heading in. Good, where they should be, where they've been hit. This one's taking 12% damage already. I'm gonna leave them up here. There's convoys moving around through here. Let's see if we can't pick a little bit more. K8, yep, and K16. K16, oh wow, nicely done. K16 is in the, it's in the red and just operating according to general good principles, good ideas. We're gonna bring her in on general principles. S45. Here, I'm going to order it to go to Shetlands. You know, yeah, and set the boundary up near truck. We're spending so much time with our submarines running back and forth to Townsville that, oh, what am I doing? Let's just go to, what am I saying? Just go to Shetlands, Shortlands. I'm using up quite a bit of the fuel running back and forth across the Coral Sea in order to refuel the ships. So let's try to put this Shortlands to work. S28 already in. Grayback, yeah, heading back as well. Okay, now I'm going to check for the torpedoes, see which ones have fired. All subs present or accounted for. Okay, we now have an aviation base force and combat engineers heading up to, where are these guys going? I'm sorry, where are you headed? Oh, Merauke, Merauke. The enemy's been taking bases here. I hope he hasn't gotten close enough to, like, this is only range of 10. His other bases up here are, that's 21 already. So I'm hoping that I think the Bettys are coming out of here. I don't think they're coming out of here yet, but I could be wrong. If they are coming out of here, we're in trouble because this is within range of bombing range. So we're trying to get them in there now. Anything else up here? Oh, ooh, Lexington drops another. Good. Every day. No. You're not critical. You're normal. You're just not that important. Not even Louisville. Normal. If it takes time, it takes time. Simple as that. Louisville, let's go pierside. No. Hold on, hold on. No, we can repair it normally, right? St. Louis, and this, they just can't repair at all, so we just got to grin and bear it, but Lexington can at least try to get that bomb hit down. Okay, tanker's coming through. The damaged destroyer Express and three harbor defense motor launches are going to try to sneak down along the coast down to Brisbane for repairs. Once loaded, there's a couple of, they're packing a couple of base forces, US, United States Air Force and a Navy one. Along with this, I'm going to take the CB regiment. I'm going to try to get it up to Hollandia. Hollandia, it's, well, we should be outside range of everything right now. From truck should be keeping us outside of range. 21, 21. That's extended range if he's got any bombers up here. And Woolleye, again, extended range. Well, 15. But I don't think Woolleye has anything yet. But I'm still, I gotta be careful, so I'm gonna send a carrier group to cover it with planes, with air cover, before we deal with this Gazmata crap. Yeah, anything else out here? Where's oh. These are my transports. That little blue speck on the background of blue speck. There it is. Oh man. Oh, I thought I'd lost track of them. Some lost them somewhere. Okay, so we've got these handled. These are. Oh crap. These APDs belong over on with the other group. Oh, for goodness sake. Just never changes, does it? Okay, these APDs were bringing stuff over and I brought them back. I didn't realize they had stuff on them. Get over to Suva, you jackass. I'm the jackass here. Replenish. Use a waypoint, please. So down. Here, right? Undock and go. Don't unload here. The other units, transport or escorts coming back, right. Replenish, disband. Anything else coming in that needs an escort? Nope, these are coming back. Okay, refuel and just get into the port, please. Sub-transport heading out. Heading out. Heading out, heading out. Okay. Okay. Heading in with destroyer escorts, good. Heading across. Right. Heading out, heading in. At Suva. These guys, oh, tankers are finished, good. Okay, what else we got here? Jackass. These guys. Oh, they all fit. Good, good, good. With a little luck, we'll finish off this turn, but I don't think they'll get them all off. Shipwise, everyone's refueled. Yep, pretty much everyone that needs it got it. The tankers waiting for the next turn, and then we'll head out with everybody else. Tanker, let's try to fix some of that, eh? These guys cannot fix. Battleship doesn't matter when you get fixed. Tanker, yeah, let's try to fix you too. And tanker. So let's try to get those dings out as best we can before you take off next turn. Kortenauer, well, it doesn't matter how much is here, so it doesn't really matter if it's. It will not fix. It will not fix. Got it. Anything else? In, out. What the heck is this one? Out. In. Right. This is Dunedin Star. How many other transports have we got here? None of them are assault trans. None of them are transports. Okay. Inbound, inbound. Let's check. Nothing happening in Panama. Oh boy. Okay, let's do Johnson Island first. Johnson Island, unloading. Still not finished, Dixie. Nothing happening up in Midway. Palmyra, we're now leaving, good. Okay, we'll refuel. John's Christmas Island is sitting well at 24,000. We're doing okay here, doing okay. Just need, yeah, we can keep coming back as often as we need it. Hold on, let's check the operations report. Someone just increased the fortifications to Karachi. Was it Rabaul? Rabaul increased fortifications Okay, to 4. Oh, there was another one, I thought. I should turn off, but I guess I missed it. I missed that warning, and I've forgotten about it since. Oh, it was Midway. I think it was Midway. Okay, Midway had built up to... Ah, okay, almost a 5. Almost a 5. So after we hit 5, we'll stop. That's right. We don't need to... Anything coming down this... I doubt anything's going to come this late stage. It's pretty late in the game. Well, for invasions, that is. I could be wrong, and then I'll lose Midway. But, well, then we'll... Okay, Pearl Harbor. We're at Pearl Harbor now. This is the group that's arrived. I'm going to replenish them from the dock them. And these carriers, I don't even know why I bother with the Jamestown. It's an AGP. It's a gunboat tender. It can do certain things and move people, but really, it's such a small amount. It's a waste of time to move 800 supplies and to use up gas for it. It's just not worthwhile. I don't know why. I'll just leave them in here. I'm going to transfer them into the dock, leave them here. But the Long Island escort carrier, this is very helpful because the escort carrier can go along with the transports wherever they go. Even the amphibious invasion, they can go with the amphibious groups. I'm going to take one of these fighter squadrons. This one's already been purchased and ready to go, but it withdraws in October. Now all these other ones, this one withdraws in October, no, September, but back in November. This one in October, back in December. This one in October, back in January. And this one in December and back in February. So lots of musical chairs with fighter squadrons. And I want to keep one on board the carriers as much as possible. So I've got the ships that are coming in right now. We're going to, okay, these guys, we're going to use some of them to bring the fighters down into the area, into the south, so that they can supplement the fighters on the carriers. I don't think we have enough fighters on carriers. We should have at least 2 squadrons on each carrier. So which one to take? I'm going to take this one. Okay, this Wildcat here. This has already been purchased. The pilots are pretty decent. Pretty decent. This is about as combat ready. They need experience. They need to be flying combat patrols. So we're going to set them for escort, and we're going to be flying combat air patrols right away. Make sure that this unit is undocked, floating, so that when we transfer them over, see, the Wildcats are currently, they're ready. They're ready to fly, they're able to fly. If the unit's docked or within the base and we transfer them over to a ship, they're assumed to be loaded by crane. See, now we flew them over, we landed on here, they're ready to fly operations. They can still fly. Otherwise, they would show up under maintenance or damage, meaning that they had been dismantled, placed aboard by crane, and had to be repaired before they could fly. So that's why I make sure they're off. The carrier is afloat and separate. Now, another thing to notice about the carrier is our maximum capacity is 16, but there's 18 aircraft on here. This is allowed because the 16 is that's maximum capacity, but you're able to carry up to 15%, no more than, it has to be less than 15%. So 10% of 16 is 1.6, so another 5% of that is 2.8, so that's 2.4 is the maximum. So it'd be 18.4 or a little bit less than 18. Anything less than 18.4 it can take, so it would be 18. So we have 18 aircraft on here. We're in the max zone. We can't carry any more, but we still are able to operate aircraft. We could put 20, I think we could probably put 20 aircraft or more on here. But the fact is, if we put 20 on, then the carrier wouldn't be able to launch or wouldn't be able to conduct any operations. So these guys are sitting here. We're going to disband. We're going to repair that one. Repair that Oh, Long Island's here? Okay. So we're gonna go critical. Long Island's critical. The Jamestown. Ah, just whenever you're ready, we are ready. We're not gonna use it. We just aren't going to find any use for it. We'll refuel the other mind control ships. Here comes the desperately short fuel transports. Okay, so we better send some escorts out to them. Surface combat. Let's send. Oh, okay, the ones that we just came in. Sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll send the destroyer minesweepers as well. Meet. And merge. These guys are headed back to Los Angeles, to San Francisco. These guys are headed in because, well, yeah, the idiot who didn't load them up with enough, didn't give them a full load along the way, right? So now we're going to send them in here. We're going to fill up with fuel. So at least it's here. There's 500,000. We want to keep this up as high as possible. But if this it's for not emergencies, but for uses like this when I screw up. Anything happening on the Panama? Nope. Here's a submarine coming out, headed for Pearl Harbor. Submarine headed for Pearl, and these headed in for Pearl. Up here we have this is a transport group that's returned, okay, refueled, and didn't disband yet. Oh well. Here's the transports that are filled with fuel and troops. That's good. 77,000 of fuel. That's a crap load of, that's a wonderful crap load of fuel that we've got on there, and we need every drop of it, every damn drop. We have escorts already set out. Okay, oops, undock, loading is complete. Go, don't let us hold you back. The units in port, we're going to make sure that they get repaired. Buchanan, all you guys get repaired. Were these, I can't remember, I think these were the ones that came in from Pearl, perhaps. Or I could be wrong. I could be wrong. No, it's too small a group for Pearl Harbor. Let's set all, oh, we can't set all categories. We can set all categories to minesweep, to shipyard, or to, but we can't set them all to high. See? No. We don't want to set them all on pier side. No, we don't want to do that. We want this one. Let's see. What if we set it on high? Would that help it? Yep. This set this one on high. Notice how we're... Oops, this one doesn't help on high. I set it on critical. Nope. This one... Okay. Then this one doesn't go on critical. Then this one has to go on critical. Both of them. Right? Everybody done here? So those two are on critical. Let's see what happens if we put all of these others on high. Shouldn't matter, right? Right? But this is not critical. This is just high. Right. Let's take a look. Only the ones in dock. Any tankers, any oilers, the AKs. The AKs, we have plenty of AKs that aren't damaged right now. And the assault and the passenger transports. Okay, I'm going to think for a moment just which units we want to send out. We have aircraft. We've already sent the aircraft, so we don't have to worry about those. Infantry wise, let's take a look. Are we needing combat power in the zone? I don't think so. Okay, are we looking for armor, artillery? Not needed. Or engineers? These are not finished. These are still recovering engineers. So this is the most advanced, most... Whoa, he's almost there! Our boy is almost recovered. Manila, ready to go back in the fight, baby. A few more motorized support squads, okay? You, the Bataan base force. Oh wait, you got a bunch to go. You got about 50 or 100 to add on still, but that's okay. So we're not really rushed for these engineers either. The only thing is, should we send any infantry? We currently have, we could buy this one out. We currently have 1400. I could splurge and just send them. Let's see, anything happening on the East Coast? Nothing. Something just arrived in Victoria. There, no, in Vancouver. Oh, here's all the Canadian commands. These are all the militia commands. I let's put them all to rest, I think. These, no, I got to put these on combat because these, they are, what the heck is this? Support an observer corps. Okay. No, the fort is on combat because it's still building. These other ones, they don't have any. These are all militia, but they don't have any engineers, so it's pointless to do anything with these guys. The anti-aircraft artillery, yeah, we'll put them on rest just to collect. Now I'm going to send these down. Actually, I'm going to send these down to, because they can be bought. They can be bought and sent if we wanted to send them. Not that we would, but we have that choice. These cannot, so I'll just leave them right here. Operational reinforcements. Oh, we have one at Lahore. Taking reinforcements, okay. Let's take a look at the one at Lahore first. Lahore, up here. Well, that's great. But it's static, so who the hell cares? I guess they just want Lahore as an air training base. It's got nothing. It's an air HQ, so it will affect the units around us. A radius of 3. Okay, that's good. But it can't move. It can't train. There's no air aviation support units. So that's kind of a waste of effort. Let me think what do you want to do with. Okay, right. And the ships that came in. See, we took in a bunch of these corvettes. But we also have to remember we took in more than these aren't our corvettes. These belong to Victoria. So, I got to send some of them back up because, yeah, I got to send a few of them back out. Now, do I send the short-ranged ones or the longer-ranged ones? Where are we? These guys are taking the short-ranged ones. Short-range or long-range? Let's see. North up here, we're still unloading. Yeah, still messing around with that. Which ones have we got in here? We have short-ranged ones, okay. So I guess that answers the question. We'll send short-ranged ones, one short-ranged one, and some YPs up here. Form escort, mine, yeah, short-range. Where are the YPs? Oh, pardon me, patrol. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That should be enough, right? Just to escort the occasional transport ship which appears. Back to the question. Which units to send south? All right, I know which two I'm going to try to buy. I'm going to try to buy the Canadian unit, the two Canadian units right here. And the parachute. No, the parachute guys will come. Okay. They're gone in 635 days. But we might find some use for these guys dropping onto islands or whatnot. Having parachute assault capability, ooh, can be convenient. So I think I'll buy these guys. They're very cheap. There's only 55 points, or one fourth would be 12, about 12 points. So that's done. The other thing I'm going to buy this Canadian brigade. Why? It's pretty much all there. It's ready to go. There's a couple of more upgrades, but I don't know when these guys will ever get their guns or whatnot. So they're pretty good fighting strength, and they don't withdraw. Unfortunately, all these damn Canadian units are so expensive. 675 to change. 600 for the Canucks. Really? They think they're worth that much, do they? Do they? I should give them to the Soviet Far East Command or something like that. Oh, that would be good. Or China Command or Southeast Asia, one of these commands. I don't know which one. We can give them to Australia British. I think I'll do that one. Just because it's, well, it just because it's gives me some flexibility when capturing bases. If you capture a base with one of these ABDA units, then I might be able to transfer some of those restricted Dutch unit survivors over here. So it makes no difference. Yeah, really makes no difference. I can't leave it as Canada Command because we won't be able to get them out of the theater. So, sure. There we go. We just spent a whole crap load of points on these guys. They're ready to go. And I could also buy the Mountain Rangers. But I'm not going to. We have the points available, but I'm not going to do so. I'm only buying it right now because right now we have two transports. We have form transport. We have two APs. I want these two APs in the area because they're assault transports. So I'm going to take one of these. I'm going to load troops. I'm going to see how if we can load the Canadian Brigade. See? Verify. Oh, we still need how much more troop capacity? So we need two of them to carry the Canadian Brigade. Even that, it's 12% and 70% safety factor. That's not enough. Well, I'll probably be leaving most of the other stuff behind. So I'm going to need another ship. Oh, who's who's fast and willing to take these guys? I'll take a third ship. Okay. Load the Canadians. I'm hoping that'll be enough. Okay. Accept the load. Done. Form another one. Transport. I wasn't really worried about getting these other transports in there. They're repairing, so I don't need to. Oh, shucks. Of course, I had to pick the one that was damaged, didn't I? Let's try to get that out of there. Ship. Adjust. Reallocate. Accept. So all we do was we burned up some operations reports, operations points here. We're going to transfer this one out and transfer the other one in. This was undamaged. Why wasn't I didn't have the brains to grab this one, huh? Jeez. Everyone gets to see my stupidity in action. Okay. Verify. Yeah. Accept. Okay. This one will be okay. So we just all we did was burn some more operations points considering it. The other APs are damaged, so I'm in no rush to get them loaded. These others. Okay. So I'm going to make sure that the which AP was that we were repairing it. The AP, well, Okay. It went back and it went back into its high state for repair. So let's get them all. Yeah, right here. Critical. Critical. Let's get it done. We're going to form the other transports, though. Transport. AK. Biggest, please. I think we get them all. We're going to grab all the ones that aren't loaded, aren't damaged. So let's try to get everyone here. Let's try docking them first. We're going to load fuel. AK, largest ones first, please. Nope, nothing in port. Okay, so we managed to get pretty much everybody here. All the undamaged ones. And we'll load these other ones later. But these are all... I'm going to take out the little guys. Little guys. Little guys. We'll try to load the big guys first. See? Get the big ones with the big capacities. Let them load first. Little guys can fill up with something else. Snacks. Fast food. Whatever. So that's another 75,000 worth of supplies. Fuel we get in there. It just seems like such a shift. You're only transporting at 50% capacity, but you got it because we need the freaking fuel. We can't maneuver. The ones carrying troops, this troop transport will grab. The rest of it will grab supplies, so we'll have some supplies available, and that's another reason why I chose to send some troops, because those troops will. The transports themselves will bring supplies enough to keep them going there. Okay, so operationally we don't have any other to worry. Nope. Aircraft check. No undetected reinforcements. We were looking at Pearl Harbor already. So Pearl Harbor has ships coming in, going out. We're going to meet these guys. Yep, that works. These guys are heading back. Yep, these are the amphibious units heading back. One thing I'm going to try here, Tulagi. Oh, no, Tulagi hasn't built up far enough yet. But here... Fortification-wise, okay, we're up at level 7 maximum. So I'm going to move these. I've got a bunch of liberators here. Liberators, these are army. There's only 8 of them in the command, but they've been hitting pretty well. They've been doing very well on the naval strike. And these guys are, well, liberators are not quite as tough as fortresses, but they're okay. So I'm going to transfer them over to Shortlands. I know the bomb situation there, the supply situation is already kind of weak, but if I get them over to Shortlands and have them flying naval strike, we can go out to a radius of 19. Let's go up to maximum and back one. I want to see how well they do in the attack roll, because from here. Range of 19. That's just monster. Not out to there, but we keep getting these damned transport little aircraft that sneak by us, and we can't seem to hit them, or just trying to dance around the engagement envelope. So I'm thinking about using them here, and possibly using liberators up here to try for strikes on truck. The problem with these aircraft are their serviceability is just so low, a 4. That means they're generally, if you're going to strike, you'll fly every 4, maybe 5 days. Once every 4 or 5 days, just so that the planes can recover from fatigue and whatnot, and damage and everything else. So they don't fly very well. They don't fly very intensively. So I may not be able to keep in this role. And when they bomb something, they use a lot of bombs. That means they eat up a lot of supply. And I'm already having some supply concerns out here. So for that reason, we're at 89, 82. Okay, hold on. Do I need to get any other aircraft out of here? The Devastators. Well, I think I can live with it for now. I can live with it for now. Short term. We've also got marauders on here who have an excellent long-range strike capability too. 9. So I might just be duplicating their efforts. The 9 brings them up to here, and I'm worried that if the enemy brings in more carriers, I could lose them. I could have them shredded. But we'll fly them. We'll fly them. The Liberators, I think, have a few more machine guns on them. Let's see, aircraft data. How many? Yeah, they've got 50 caliber front, starboard. I think that's starboard. Rear. Top turret, I think that is. Bottom. I don't know what BR stands for, but so they've got a few more, and they're tough for the enemy fighters to shoot down. On second thought, it might have been better to keep them in here and fly the strike mission inside, keep the coral sea sealed, not sealed off, but at least threatened. Whatever. We're over here. What's done is done. We'll see how they work over. It doesn't show the range of these strikers, though. Oh, well. Thresher fires a pair of torpedoes at a transport. Duds. K-18 evades a patrol boat. Tuna evades a subchaser. Sculpin fires two torpedoes at a coastal freighter. Duds. Truant is hit 3 times near Singapore. Yeah. Dangerous place. Silversides fires torpedoes at a transport, hits it, and then goes in with the guns, but also gets a couple shots back at her. Takes some damage. Temelo, bombed. Pakoi, bombed. K-18 evades a patrol boat. Sorbaya, Sculpin fires a pair of torpedoes, duds. Oh, assault landing at Dobo. Dobo is here. Dobo. So yeah. So I'm hopefully get that base up before the enemy starts seizing all these bases. The last few bases. Spearfish fires torpedoes near in the Makassar Strait at a transport. Duds. Sowry fires a full spread at a destroyer. Duds. Tarpon fires and gets a hit against a transport. Trigger fires two torpedoes. Duds. The Burmese headquarters corps is bombed near Mandalay. Again, bombed. Yep, free training for the enemy. Free training. Chusien bombed. Again. Timulo bombed. The survivors. The Benkulen survivors are bombed. Darwin takes under air attack. We destroy 7 out of the 16 attackers. 41 aircraft fighters up. Cagayan bombed. Timbulo bombed. Bacolod bombed. Oh boy, another one. K-18 is attacked but evades. Totog fires, gets torpedo hits, and then engages with guns. Tarpon fires, goes and engages with guns. That's a one shell hit. Bombardment, Kyukang. Destroys another unit squad. Damn it. Bombardment, Kwe Sui. Bombardment, Cebu. Deliberate attack, Anyang. 22-1 odds. Massive! Oh, wow! Massive Japanese casualties. Well, okay, massive. Yeah, 5,000. That's massive. That's massive! But we also lose 12. Oh, that pretty heavy casualties on our side, too. So, 2 units destroyed. Probably the mixed brigade and the Mongol one of the cavalry divisions. Or maybe both cavalry divisions. They're pretty light units. Deliberate attack to Dobo. We have nothing with which to protect it. Captured. Ah, there you go. Midway expands to 5. Good.